Hello students, once again welcome to English literature class. Today once again I am teaching Merchant of Venice. Okay, look here once again, Shakespeare's The Merchant of Venice. Okay, this Merchant of Venice is not for only class 10, 9. Okay, it's also for class 8. Okay, class 9 and 10 you already read act 1 scene 1 and it is a revision for you all, and class 8 you all are newcomer. Okay, so let's recap. And today I'm going to teach from line 163. Okay, and I will continue up to the end of act 1 scene 1. Okay, the end up to here I will teach today. Clear? That is up to here, and act 1 scene 2 I will start in next video. So let's recap a little bit. Antonio, a rich merchant, suffers from his inexplicable melancholy, that is extreme melancholy. Melancholy means sadness. His friend Salerno and Salerno suggest that Antonio is probably worried about the safety of his merchant ship, which are exposed to storms at sea and to attack by pirates. Pirates, sea robber. Antonio denies that he is concerned about his merchandise. He is concerned about his merchandise as his capital has been distributed widely and not entrusted to a single ship or one financial venture. Salerno and Salerno leave him as Bassanio arrives with Gratiano and Lorenzo. Gratiano plays comments on Antonio's sullen and undue silence. According to him, Antonio is sad because he attaches too much importance to the opinion of the world. Lorenzo and Gratiano then depart. Being alone with Bassanio, Antonio asks him about his forthcoming mysterious sacred pilgrimage to a lady. This gives Bassanio an opportunity to come to the point. He has known Antonio for a long time and has received financial help from him many times before. He hopes that Antonio will help him once more and that he will be able to repay this time all that he owes him. Okay, now let's start from this part, that is, in Belmont is a lady richly left. Okay, up to here I have completed. Okay, up to this speech I have completed. Now let's start. Bassanio is telling, okay, in a lady in Belmont is a lady richly left, and she is fair and fairer than her word of wondrous virtue sometimes from her eyes. Okay, Antonio wanted to know about the lady whom Bassanio wants to meet. So Bassanio is giving reply that in Belmont there's a lady who has been left a lot of wealth. Okay, she's a rich heiress of wealth. Okay, she is beautiful, but even more beautiful than her face, her wonderful virtue. And Bassanio, sometimes from her eyes, got speechless messages of love. And the name of that girl is Portia, and she's not in the least inferior to Cato's daughter and Brutus Portia. Look here, her name is Portia. Nothing undervalue means she should not be undervalue to Cato's daughter. Cato's daughter Portia. Cato's daughter was also Portia and Brutus' wife. Cato's daughter Portia was Brutus' wife. Now Bassanio is telling that this Portia is no less than that Portia. That Portia means Cato's daughter Portia. The vast world is not unaware of a beauty and virtue, because high-born and well-known suitors. Now look, high-born and well-known suitors from the four corners, they are coming to Belmont. Why? To take part in the lottery and to win Portia. Okay, and look, this Belmont has now become a Colchos. Okay, and everyone is coming from four part of the world to win this lady. According to the ancient Greek mythology, many adventures like Jason. Look here, the word Jason is given. Jason is an adventurer. Okay, so many adventurers like Jason want to stick the golden fleece, and even Bassanio wants to go to Belmont to take part in the lottery and to win Portia. Okay, Portia's father had made a lottery. As per the lottery, one who would win the lottery, only he can marry Portia. So everyone is coming from four corners of the world to take part in the lottery, and Bassanio also wants to go. Now Bassanio is telling to Antonio, oh my dear Antonio, if I had the money to hold a place equal to other men ready to marry Portia, my mind foretells a success that I would surely be lucky in winning this lady. Bassanio is sure that if he had money to go to Belmont, he would surely win Portia. Now Antonio is giving reply. Okay, now what reply Antonio is giving? Antonio is replying that thou knows that all my fortune at sea. Okay, Antonio is telling that thou knows. Thou means you know. Bassanio, you know that all my fortune at sea. Means I don't have money now. I don't have any cash in hand. Okay, neither have I money nor commodity. I don't have anything now to raise a present sum. Present sum means he wants, Belmont wants money. And what is that present sum? 3,000 ducats. And Antonio does not have that money. Therefore, go forth, try. But my credit camp in Venice do. Therefore, Antonio is requesting Bassanio that go and try if you can get any money in the city of Venice as a loan on my behalf. Okay, on my behalf you go and try to raise that loan. Okay, to furnish the to Belmont so that you can go to Belmont to Fair of Asia to win the lottery. Okay, go presently inquire, so will I, where money is, and I no question me, to have it of my trust or for my sake. Now what is telling? Go at once and find out where money can be got. Okay, at once you go and find out from where you can get the money, and I'm sure that I shall be able to get it, either on my credit or for the sake of your friendship. And Antonio is sure that he would get money from somewhere, and he would lend the money then to Bassanio, and Bassanio would go to Belmont to take part in the lottery. Okay, I have completed Act 1, Scene 1, and you have to all read it again and again. And I will, in my next video, I will give question pattern once again. Okay, until then, goodbye.